A Philippine finance official doesn't see the current political environment affecting the country's positive economic outlook. Finance Undersecretary Dominique Velasquez says strong fiscal policies and economic reforms are still in place. The country's economic managers earlier assured the public the economy would stay strong against domestic and external challenges. These assurances come amid the growing feud between President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and Vice President Sara Duterte.
But I think hindi yon masyado nagmamatter kasi we've proven ourselves na actually we're beyond this political noise. We're able to pass reforms. So ito nga, create more, na-pass natin. Mm-hmm. We're able to consolidate our finances. And parang kumbaga kaya tayo merong positive outlook from S&P is because may track record na tayo na nagagawa natin to kahit ano pa ang political noise.
The Philippines records a surprise budget surplus in October. The Treasury Bureau says revenue collection saw double-digit growth at 22.6% last month, which outpaced the 11% increase in expenditures and led to a 6.3 billion peso surplus. The agency cites strong growth in both tax and non-tax collections for the rise in revenues. Because of that, the country's year-to-date deficit narrowed to 964 billion pesos, better than the 1.02 trillion peso gap in the same period last year. The Bureau adds the country's deficit to GDP ratio now stands at a manageable 5.14% of GDP for the first three quarters of 2024, well below the 5.6% target for the year. Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Just Eat Takeaway, which announced its plan to delist from the London Stock Exchange next month in a blow to the UK's ambitions to attract more tech firms to its local bourse. London-listed shares of the Dutch food delivery company last traded lower by 1.4%. Also in focus, shares of Dell after the company's fourth quarter guidance fell short of Wall Street expectations. Shares of the tech company plunged nearly 13% in pre-market trading. We're also keeping a close watch on HP after it reported weaker than expected earnings guidance for its fiscal 2025 first quarter. HP shares sank 9% on the news.
Asian markets ended Wednesday trade on a mixed note. The Nikkei 225 led underperformers hit by a stronger yen. The safe haven currency climbed to a three-week high against the U.S. dollar, which fell on the back of sagging treasury yields ahead of the PCE price index data. Meanwhile, Chinese markets shined even as data showed China's industrial profits plunged 10% in October. As for the local bourse, the PSEI posted a second day of losses, with decliners beating advancers 2-1.
In that respect, maybe I'm a little bit more positive. We've heard all the bad news has come out. Okay. And, you know, take a look at the PSEI companies. There are quite a few that should lead the growth and, you know, appreciate and an appreciation of the index over December. Maybe if we keep it to just that time frame. So infrastructure companies will be there. That will always be positive. The power companies, you know, still positive in that respect. And the consumer companies, maybe people are doing late consumption, but you know, we hope that we will see the spike in December.
A notable stock move within the region, shares of Samsung tumbled nearly 3.5% as the tech giant announced leadership changes in its memory and foundry chip units. That's as it struggles to catch up to SK Hynix and TSMC in the booming AI chip market.